Amen. Now we can pass over to David.
All right, well, thank you very much. And it's always great to hear Amory because it's such an inspiring vision and also an inspiring reality because you can actually see many of these things happening today. And yet, here we are with emissions globally continuing to rise. So if you listen to Amory, you might think, well, it's all sorted, emissions are falling, job done, off we go. And I'm not disputing anything that you say. Yet emissions are rising, they rose from 2017 to 2018 by over 20%, and similarly the year before. And this continues to happen. One of the challenges that we have in Shell is to look at this issue and think about the long-term direction of the company. And I'm privileged to work in the Shell Scenario team that's coming up to its 50th anniversary. And we've been tasked really with grappling with this issue. How do you meet the goals of the Paris Agreement? Last year we released a new scenario that looks at just that problem. And what's interesting about it is that you recognize, as Amory said, that all the pieces to solve this problem and to get to net zero emissions, which is the conference has been about, are on the table today. There really isn't anything missing. You know, we know how to generate electricity in a carbon-free way. We know how to apply that to perhaps industrial processes. We know how to turn that electricity into hydrogen and use that in various places. But yet still, emissions continue to rise. And the challenge we really face is not just applying that set of technologies and getting them to work in the way that was described, but doing that in a very timely manner. And it's time that we always seem to come up against, and which in our own scenario thinking we struggle to come to terms with. We've looked historically at the energy system, and time again, it seems to take a generation for technologies to sort of come out of the first implementation to something that resembles meaningful scale. And meaningful scale is about 1-2% of the energy system. It's taken the best part of 50 years for solar PV to go from sort of first application on satellites in the early 70s to the first station, actually a power station built in the US, which was actually built by an oil company, to 2% of the world's electricity generation today, although it is rising very, very rapidly. And it's that second period that can actually be quite fast. What we found is that applying all of these types of constraints, that net zero emissions is an achievable objective, but we struggle to see it being achieved, say, before about 2070. And this is a tussle with where we are now, that the world really needs to achieve this as early as 2050. So the technologies are there, the timing isn't quite there. And so therefore you perhaps look to, you know, the governments to try and pull this along even faster. And there are a number of ways in which this might be done. For example, there's feed-in tariffs that we've seen deployed quite effectively through the UK and other parts of the world. There's tax credits that work very well in the United States with deploying wind and solar. There's carbon pricing that has worked to some extent in Europe, but has been very volatile and mixed in its effectiveness. But the sort of policy framework that the Paris Agreement might require just isn't there today, and it's still missing. And so this challenge keeps coming back in the scenario thinking as to what is going to happen for the stars to align in terms of policy, technology, and also social pull to get governments to recognize that they have a license to introduce a set of policies. And we've seen that struggle just in recent couple of years. The desire by the French government to put in additional carbon taxes into that economy was pushed back very hard by the yellow vest movement. the implementation of a carbon pricing system in the province of Ontario in Canada was taken down by a subsequent government. My own country, Australia, carbon pricing has been on again, off again, like a light switch, and pretty, you know, not a good outcome. So all the pieces are there. We know what to do. We know how to do it. It's now really a question of that implementation and the societal call to see it happen. Thank you very much.